Hi, I am Murali. I am a program manager for the Visual Studio Editor team. In this release of Visual Studio 2013, we took three of the most popular productivity power tools extensions and shipped them in the box as full-fledged features. So in the 2013 version of Power Tools, you'd think we have fewer features, right? Well, in this release of Power Tools 2013, we are introducing not just three, but 11 new features. In this video, I'll be showing you some of these amazing new features we have added to Productivity Power Tools 2013. The first feature we have added is called the Peak Help feature. This feature allows you to fetch the MSDN documentation for types and display it in line inside the editor. You can right-click on any type in the editor and click on the Peak Help command or the Alt F1 key to fetch the MSDN documentation for the type and display it in line. This is a full browser control, so you can navigate to other links. You can even do things like find. You can click on the Promote Document button to open this link in a real browser, or you can hit Escape to go back to your editor. This feature is extremely useful to know about new types without having to leave Visual Studio. The second feature we have introduced in Power Tools is called the Solution Explorer squiggles. If I open the Solution Explorer, it is showing me squiggles on certain files. This feature shows squiggles on files in the Solution Explorer when there are errors, warnings, or messages. I can hover on these files and get a quick preview of all these errors. I can double-click on any item to quickly navigate to that point inside the editor. I can also filter the Solution Explorer to just the list of files that have errors or warnings or messages. This feature is extremely useful to get a quick view of the health of your solution without having to open the error list. The third feature I want to talk about is the Block Structure Visualizer. This feature creates markers in the editors corresponding to different blocks in your code. For example, in this file, I have different lines for different blocks in my code. So this line corresponds to a for block, this line corresponds to my class, my namespace, and so forth. The lines are colored differently depending on the type of block. And if the starting of the block is scrolled off the screen, it gives me a preview above my file. For example, if I hover on this line, it shows me that this block corresponds to the construct matrix method inside the processor class. If I hover over this line, it tells me this block is the class processor, and this block is for namespace, and so forth. This extension can be really helpful to understand the structure of your code base when they're scrolled out of view. The fourth feature we have introduced is called double-click to maximize windows. This feature allows you to double-click on any window inside Visual Studio to quickly maximize it to full screen. You can double-click on the full screen again to dock it back to the original position. The feature works not just for tool windows, but even for documents. So I can double-click on a document to quickly maximize it to full screen and double-click again back to my original position. This feature is extremely useful if you want to get quick full-screen views of certain things inside Visual Studio. The fifth feature we have introduced is called the timestamp margin in the debug output window. If I open the output window and open the debug section of it, I have timestamps corresponding to different debug messages. The feature is very useful if you have a large number of debug messages to understand the times each of the messages was created. The sixth feature we have introduced is an improvement to the Quick Task extension that was introduced in the previous version of Power Tools. For example, if you want to turn line numbers on in the editor, you can simply type line num on and then immediately turn on line numbers inside the editor. You can search for all the tasks available to you by typing at tasks and search for the letter E. And this lists all the tasks provided by the Quick Task extension. There are over 32 tasks from which you can choose. The most popular of these tasks is called the Present On task. The Present On task bumps up the editor and the environment fonts to optimize the layout for presentations. A popular feature request we had for the Present On extension was to allow people to customize the font sizes and font families for the Present On task. So in this release, we have added this task called Present Edit, which allows you to open an XML file and customize the exact font family and font size you want for your Present On task. The seventh feature we have added is actually an improvement to the Document Tabwell extension. The Document Tabwell extension colorizes document tabs depending on the files that the tab belongs to. You can customize the document tab by clicking on the Customize option. And in this release, we have added an option to show icons on the document tab. So by checking this option, we show you icons right on the document tab. So if you have a solution with a large number of languages or different types of files, this extension can really help you narrow down on the file that you're looking for. The eighth feature we have added is an improvement to the Control-Click Go-To Definition feature in the previous versions of Power Tools. The Control-Click feature allows you to navigate to definitions by control-clicking on a symbol. And in this release, we have made it even more easy by opening peak when you control-click on a symbol. For example, if I control-click on this symbol, it shows me the definition inside the peak view right below my symbol. Of course, there's an option which you can customize. So if you prefer control-click to go to definition, you can always go and customize it. The ninth feature we have added is an improvement to the HTML copy extension. This extension allows you to copy code as HTML and paste into your blog sites or any HTML editor. In this release of Power Tools, we have added an option that allows you to copy your code as HTML. So this copies your code as HTML markup. So if you have an editor that does not support WYSIWYG, you can directly paste the HTML content inside it. So as you can see, the code was copied along with HTML tags. The 10th feature we have added is an improvement to the undo close document feature we had in previous versions of Power Tools. So if you close a bunch of documents in the Document tab, you can click on the File menu, and you have an option called Recently Closed Documents, which allows you to open any document that you closed recently. Finally, the 11th feature we have added in this release of Power Tools is called the Match Margin. This feature highlights all the text matches for any token in the editor. So if I place my caret on system, it highlights all the occurrences of system in my file as well as in the scroll bar. So for example, if I click on public, the scroll bar shows me two markers corresponding to this text public. So that was the 11th feature we have added in Power Tools this release. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I'm sure you'll love using Product Query Power Tools 2013. Download it today on the visualstudiogallery.com website. Thank you.